Central Texas is prime breeding ground for rattlesnakes, and summer is the height of snake season. But for some people, knowing the steps to take after a bite is not so clear. KXAN's Gigi Barnett takes a closer look at where to go and what to do.
Such as that doggy in the window.
Britt and Brenda Meek love the hill country view from their backyard in Llano until a couple of weeks ago when they spotted something they never wanted to see.
I was so scared. Screamed so loud that it might have drowned it out, but it was just right by my left foot.
This was it, a rattlesnake longer than they care to remember, and it's not their first sighting of one either.
We've seen 9 or 10 little bitty ones that up to maybe about like that. But that's the first time we've seen a big one.
But what concerns the Meeks the most is if they come across another rattlesnake and one of them is bitten, do they head to the ER or call 911? The answer wasn't so clear.
We don't always get good cell coverage out here to call 911.
If you've been bitten by a snake and you're being transported by 911, you'll be transported to a place that has the antivenom. Okay. If you're driving yourself, that's another variable into the equation of, did you drive to a place that doesn't stop the antivenom?
Most rattlesnake bites happen in June, according to the Texas Poison Center Network. And last year, rattlesnakes struck more than 200 times statewide. St. David's ER physician, Dr. Ryan McCorkle, says most large hospitals have the antivenom stocked and ready to go. But he says after a bite, don't try to make the situation better.
No tourniquet. Don't make a cut over it. Don't suck the poison out. All those old school methods have been proven not to work. It's get to the facility and get the antivenom.
I'm Gigi Barnett, KXAN News.
Antivenom can save your life, but it doesn't come cheap. Each vial costs about $2,500. The treatment requires a few vials on average. A professor at Texas A&M University's College of Veterinary Medicine says it is not uncommon for medical bills to total $50,000 or more after a snake bite. How much of that you end up paying out of pocket depends on your insurance plan. We want to know how common it is for people to be bitten by snakes and how often bites become fatal. Well, the Texas Department of State Health Services says only about 7,000 people are bitten by rattlesnakes across the country each year. Only 0.2% of those people die from the bites, which works out to 1 out of every 500. In Texas, that means only 1 or 2 bites become fatal each year, and experts say that's usually because of delayed treatment. Central Texas is home to a number of venomous snakes, not just rattlers. Treatment depends on the type of snake, and certain types of antivenom are becoming increasingly less available. We have more about why supplies are shrinking and what people are doing about it. It's online for you now at KXAN.com.